Today we'll learn about periodic properties. So what are periodic properties? We actually seen what is periodic table and how it is classified before the video. So this video tells about the periodic properties, how the elements are arranged. Now, the position of an element in the periodic table is determined by the electronic configuration. For example, sodium electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 1. So this is the first shell, this is the second shell, and this is the third shell. So the shells are nothing but periods, and the valency outermost electronic shell is the group. So since there are three shells, it belongs to the third period. Since there is one electron in the outermost shell, it belongs to the first group. So based on this, the position of the element in the periodic table is determined. So let's see about the groups and periods. So groups. So what are groups? So groups. Group is the those which are arranged in the columns. So what happens in the group is the number of electrons remains same, which means valency electrons. So the number of shells increases. So as the number of shells increases, the atomic radius or radii increases. So what happens is here, the valency electron will be the same when you go down the group, and the atomic radii increases because the number of shells increases. So the properties are similar since the valency electrons are same. So this is about groups. Whereas if you take periods are those which are in the rows. This is the row. So what happens to the valency electrons? The valence electrons increases by 1 at E of each element. So sodium, for example, if you take sodium is 2, 8, 1. So magnesium will be 2, 8, 2. So there will be increase of 1 electron in the valency shell as you go by one element. So the number of shells remains the same. So as the number of shells remains the same, the atomic radii decreases. So what happens here is the elements switch from metallic property to the non-metallic property. So here we can say the number of electrons increases by 1 by each element. Here the number of electrons remains the same. This is about groups and periods. They are classified in the periodic table. Now we shall learn about the periodicity. So one which is important in this periodic properties. So periodicity is the one, the repetition of the similar properties at regular intervals of the atomic radius. So periodicity. So what periodicity definition says is that, so there will be similar properties of the elements which have a similar, which have the same valency electron, that is 7. So for example, if you take fluorine, bromine and iodine. So fluorine is 9, chlorine is 17, bromine is 35 and iodine is 53. So what is the electronic configuration? This will be 2 and then 7. This will be 2, 8 and then 7. This will be 2, 8, 18 and then 7. This will be 2, 18, 32 and 7. So if you look out the down the group, fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, so we can see the valency shell has electrons 7, which means they have same electronic valency shell. Since they have same electronic valency shell, the properties of them are similar. So if you take so periodicity is the electronic configuration. So if we know the electronic configuration, then we'll know the properties of this. So all these have same electronic valency shell, so the properties of these will be similar. So what are the properties of these? Fluorine, chromine, bromine, iodine have a similar properties. So first property is they are non-metals. So since they are non-metals, they form acidic oxides. Since they form acidic oxides, they have a negative charge. So since they have negative charge, they act as a strong oxidizing agents. So since they have strong oxidizing agents, and they will have high reactivity. Since they have high reactivity, they react with hydrogen to form halides. So these are the properties of this. So fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, they will have all these properties. So because they have a outermost electronic shell is same. So this is about this. So electronic configuration plays a very important role in this periodicity and the periodic properties. So next, so what is the property of electronic configuration? So how do we predict the properties? First thing is, we should know the atomic number. As we know atomic number, we will come to know what is electronic configuration. If we know electronic configuration, we'll come to know what are the valency electrons. If we know the valency electrons, we will know the valency. So by knowing valency, we can predict the properties of elements. So this is the key point. So next is the periodic properties. So periodic properties, the properties of the elements which change at a regular intervals with atomic number. So first property, there are many properties like atomic radius, ionization potential, electron affinity, electronegativity, metallic character and non-metallic character. First we will study about the atomic radius. So first, what is atomic radius? So if you take this as a nucleus, if you take this as the atom, so the distance between the center of the nucleus to the outermost electronic shell, this distance is known as atomic radius. So what are the factors influencing this atomic radius? So what are the factors? So first factor is the number of shells. So as the number of shells increases, so the atomic radius also increases. Okay, this is the first factor. The second factor is the nuclear charge. So the nuclear charge, as the nuclear charge increases, so the attraction between the nucleus and the atom will be more if the nuclear charge increases. So if there is more attraction, the nuclear charge increases. So as the nuclear charge increases, the atomic radius decreases, because the forces of attraction increases only if the distance is very small. So these two are the factors. So what are the variations? So what are the variations? First we will see down the group. So down the group is this. So as we come down. So what happens to the atomic radius? So first is atomic radius, right? So atomic radius increases. Why? Because as we come down, the number of shells increases and the distance between the nucleus and the outermost electronic shell increases. So as the number of shells increases, atomic radius also increases. The second one is the nuclear charge. So as we come down the group, the nuclear charge decreases. Because the number of shells increases, the distance increases, but the forces of attraction decreases since the distance is more. So this is down the group. If you take along the period, first thing is atomic radius decreases. So along the period is this. So as we go from left to right, the atomic radius decreases because the number of shells remains the same. But whereas nuclear charge increases because the number of shells decreases and the valency electrons increases, the nuclear charge increases because the forces of attraction will be very more when you compare to that of the down the group. So these are the factors and these are the variations of the atomic radius. So next property, this is one of the periodic property. So next